where the tetrahedral and octahedral voids are present in the cubic system. For that, let us discuss FCC system. So in FCC, first tell me how many effective atoms are there. Yes, in FCC, number of effective atoms equals to 4. How it is 4? In FCC, face-centered cubic system, number of effective atoms, how it is 4? In FCC, atoms are present at corners, 8 corners, so 8 into 1 by 8 plus. Atoms are present at the face centers also. That's why 6 into 1 by 2, 8 into 1 by 8, 1 plus 6 into 1 by 2, 3, 1 plus 3, 4. So number of effective atoms in FCC is 4. Now, number of tetrahedral voids, how many? I said earlier that number of tetrahedral voids equals to 2 into number of effective atoms. So 2 into Z effective. That means 2 into 4. That means 8 tetrahedral voids there will be. Similarly, octahedral voids, how many? Octahedral voids is equal to number of effective atoms. That means Z effective, how many in FCC? 4. That's why octahedral voids are 4. Now let's see in FCC where the tetrahedral and octahedral voids are present. First, for tetrahedral voids, see, this is cubic system. This is cubic system. Now let us consider any body diagonal. So in FCC, where the atoms are? Yes, in FCC, atoms are present in 8 corners and 6 face centers. Let us take any body diagonal. Here, let us compare this body diagonal. This is a body diagonal. Why it is body diagonal? Because this is one corner atom. This is its opposite corner atom on other side. Now, these two are body diagonal atoms. Now, tetrahedral voids, how to locate in this FCC geometry? FCC geometry means, see here, this is FCC geometry. At each face center, there is an atom, and its back side also, at the center, one atom, front side face also, one atom. So, this is FCC geometry. In FCC geometry, if you take a body diagonal, if you take a body diagonal at a 1/4 distance from the corner, how many body diagonals are possible in this? Yes, we have total 8 corners. If each two opposite corners give a one body diagonal, then 8 corner atoms give how many body diagonals? Yes, 4 body diagonals. Now, tetrahedral voids, where they are present in FCC? See, from the corner at 1/4 distance. So if you take this body diagonal, its length is, you know, body diagonal length how much? Body diagonal is equal to root 3a. Earlier I explained how root 3a. So this is body diagonal, so its distance is root 3a. Now at 1/4 distance, suppose it is root 3a by, suppose this distance root 3a by 4. This distance also root 3a by 4. So along each body diagonal, there will be two tetrahedral voids. So for 4 body diagonals, how many tetrahedral voids are possible? Yes, 8 tetrahedral voids. So 8 tetrahedral voids in FCC, they are present at 1/4 distance from the corner along the body diagonal. So from this corner at 1/4 distance and from that corner at 1/4 distance. That's why in FCC system, there are total 8 tetrahedral voids, because Z effective is 4. Tetrahedral voids must be double the number of effective atoms. So 8 how? Along each body diagonal at 1/4 distance from each corner, there will be a tetrahedral void. In that way, total tetrahedral voids in FCC, 8. Now, question is, between two tetrahedral voids, what is the minimum distance? See, I said earlier that total body diagonal length is root 3a. Total body diagonal length root 3a. From this body, from this corner root 3a by 4, and from that corner also root 3a by 4. Let it be tetrahedral void. Between these two, what is the distance now? That is root 3a by 4. From this corner root 3a by 4, from this corner root 3a by 4. Then what is the distance between these two tetrahedral voids? Its distance is root 3a by 2. So along the body diagonal, between the two tetrahedral voids of FCC, the distance is root 3a by 2. So this is about tetrahedral voids in FCC system. You know, all the tetrahedral voids are located inside the unit cell. See, along the body diagonal at 1/4 distance from the corner means where the tetrahedral void is present. Tetrahedral void is present always inside the system. That's why all the atoms that present in tetrahedral voids are complete atoms. It's not a part of atom. All the atoms that present in tetrahedral voids are complete atoms. That means no part, no 1 by 2, no 1 by 8, no 1 by 4. It is complete atom because tetrahedral voids all are present inside the system, that's why. Now, let's see about octahedral voids where they are present in FCC. In FCC, what is the Z effective? It is 4. In FCC, Z effective is 4. That's why there will be octahedral voids total 4. One octahedral void is at the center. For a cubic system, this is cubic system. For this cubic system, where the octahedral voids is, voids are, in this four octahedral voids, one is at body center, one octahedral void is at body center. Body center, how body center makes an octahedral void? Because this body center is having six face-centered atoms. The six face-centered atoms around this body center make a octahedral void. So, face-centered atoms, six face-centered atoms of a cube, of a face-centered cube, make a octahedral void. So, the gap, the empty space between all these six face centers is nothing but octahedral void. So, one octahedral void is body center. So, any atom at the body center of FCC is a complete atom. Now, what about other three octahedral voids? The remaining three octahedral voids are at edge centers. Where they are? Yes, at edge centers. But see, these are edge center atoms. Edge center. Edge center means it is not a complete atom. Earlier I said that edge center atom contributes only 1/4 to the total atom. You know, edge center atom is also considered as an octahedral void. Edge center atom means it is the atom present in octahedral void. How from the edge center octahedral void is formed? Yes, the octahedral void from edge center is formed from, see, these two corners and this face center and backside face center. So from one unit cell, four atoms participate, and from another unit cell, two atoms participate. So here, with this unit cell, some other unit cells are joined. So in those also some atoms, corner atoms, face center atoms, those atoms also participate in forming octahedral void. So edge center atom is nothing but it is in octahedral void. Edge center atom means it is the atom in octahedral void. But octahedral void, how to say? See, this is an octahedral void. How to say it is an octahedral void? These two corners, this face center and backside face center, and two atoms from other unit cells. So total how many atoms? From the same unit cell, four atoms, and from other unit cells, two atoms. So these six atoms now form an octahedral void. So it is this edge center octahedral void is not a complete atom. It's a part of atom. How much part? Yes, edge center atom is 1/4 of total atom. That's why how many edge centers we have total? Yes, we have 12 edge centers. 12 into each edge center contributes how much? 1/4. So 12 into 1 by 4 gives what? 3. So in that way, 3 tetrahedral voids plus 1 body center. 1 body center, 12 edge centers, they form. So here 12 edge centers form 3 octahedral voids, 1 octahedral void at body center. Body center forms 1 complete octahedral void. That means 1 complete atom is present in at body center, whereas some part of atom is present at edge center. Part of atom means 1/4. Only 1/4 atom is present at the edge center. So always remember, edge centers are nothing but octahedral voids. So in FCC, only 1 octahedral void contains complete atom. Remaining octahedral voids contain some part of atom, not a complete atom. Because they are edge centers. That means these edge centers share some other unit cells. That's why atom lies in other unit cells also. But all tetrahedral voids are present inside the unit cell. But octahedral voids, only 1 octahedral void that is present inside the unit cell. Remaining all octahedral voids are in combination with some other unit cells. So this is about locating tetrahedral and octahedral voids in FCC system.